Right, good morning children. So today I'm going to discuss about the our third class. What does it mean? That is a continuation of the topic. Is the second topic we are continuing the page number 208. What is that? Our class is a third class, okay? So grade 3, right? So in our class, third class, I'm going to discuss with you. What does it mean? Continuation of this one, page number 208. I'm going to start with that because we discussed them already about the second lesson, animals, food, and more. Okay, and now, okay, animals breathe through lungs, gills, or hair holes. Okay, now the animals are right to breathe, yes or no? So, all living things are right to breathe or not? So, definitely all living things are right to breathe it. Okay, so clear? Understood all of you? Right. Now we'll start the explanation about the animals. We'll continue the animals breathe through the lungs. Animals breathe through lungs, gills, or hair holes. So through what? Lungs, gills, air holes. Okay, air holes. So listen, animals breathe through lungs, gills, air holes means simple logic I am going to say. So what we discussed already discussed about the each and every object or each and every living thing can breathe either using the lungs. Different type of parts are there to breathe it. For example, you can go for the gills of the fish. The fish is inside of the water or not? So definitely the fish is inside of the water only. How the fish is right to live means because it is also right to breathe, but their category, for example, we are breathing with a lungs, yes or no? Our human beings means that is a boys and girls and everyone is a human beings are right to breathe. Animals also can breathe the with a nose, means there is a lungs inside. What it will be there? There is an internal organs we call already, right? There is a lungs. The lungs are helpful to our body to breathe it. So same as is the fish is also there, that is also having lungs type of arrangement, but the lungs are not present. Another things are there. What does it mean? Another thing means another name is a gills. That animals, that kind of the fishes are containing the gills. Not only that, the fishes, the dolphins. So the fish category, all living things inside of our water is totally using as a gills. Correct, my children? Yes. For example, you know that you can go for the plant. Plant is also a living thing or not? Yeah, in lower classes you already learned about the plant is also one of the living thing. Can you guess what is that? The plant is also ready to breathe or not? Yes, definitely the plant is also ready to breathe. How the plants are ready to breathe? The plants will breathe by using of a stomata. What is that? Stomata. So what is the use of the stomata? Stomata is nothing but the stomata containing some air holes. There is a small holes will be present inside of the stomata. Then what is that? It will be using like a, the air is right to take in and air is taking out. It is just take in and out. So these kind of the process is right to present. Okay, na? This kind of the process is right to present. The air is receiving and going outside. And children, you just know about the stomata is a leaves. There is a very interesting topic means our we need the human beings need that oxygen, correct or not? But there is a plants will need, that is a plants will need, what is that? Oxygen giving outside and receiving carbon dioxide. But our procedure is different. Our procedure is opposite side of the that kind of the processor. What is the opposite side? I mean simple logic I'll say. So plants need carbon dioxide and giving out oxygen, but human beings are giving carbon dioxide, giving outside to the carbon dioxide, receiving oxygen. Reverse, na? Plants need carbon dioxide. We are giving carbon dioxide. Plant is releasing oxygen. Human beings receiving oxygen. Got it, na? So these are the things are there. So that is the whole surface stomata in a plant is also one of the breathing element in our. It's a different type of animals and plants and everything is right to breathe by using of this special category things. Okay, na children? Now, insects such as grasshoppers and cockroaches have their hair holes along the sides of their body for breathing. So, listen carefully. The along the sides of a breathing means simple. See here, there is a, you can guess that, what does it mean? See, all children, once you observe that small insects are there, ma. You know, the grasshopper is there, yes or no? The grasshopper, a cockroach, and the next one is a, not only this one, it's a different small insects also, like eagle, sorry, not eagle, like a, what does it mean? Mosquito. So, this kind of the small things are there, na. So these are all are right to breathe. The how it is possible? Any nose is there? Lungs are there? No. Like a stomata, anything is there? No. Air holes will be right to present. We call it as air holes. Okay, na? The fish breathe with a gills and plant breathe through the pores in the leaves called as a stomata. And so different type of insects or small animals are right to breathe with a air holes. So these are the different categories of a animals are having their own breathing organs. Okay, na? Right. Animals have sense organs. Do you know sense organs? What is mean by sense organs? So sense means we feel. Okay, either listening music, we can feel it. So getting smell is we can feel it. By seeing movie, we can feel with our eyes. So by tasting, eating food, that is a taste with our tongue. Yes or no? If anyone hot body or cool body will touch to our skin, this is also right to feel. Yes or no, children? The sense organs are 5 sense organs are there. Listen carefully. So what is the 5 sense organs? One is the ears. Anything first you can continue comes from our head. Okay, so ears are this is one of the sense organs, and eyes are also one of the sense organs, and nose is also one of the sense organs. 3 completed, na? Ears, eyes, and nose. And next one comes to the another part, that is a tongue. That tongue is also one of the sense organs, right? And next one is a skin. Our body is covered with a skin, na? The skin is also one of the sense organ. These are the 5 sense organs are right to present in our day-to-day life. In our body covered with a skin, that is also one of the sense organ, right? Okay, so here this is a the ears means listening sounds. Listen carefully. Ears means the listening sounds, sense organs. Okay, so sense organs. Okay, the sense organs, 5 sense organs are there. First one is a ear or ears, and second one is the eyes, and third one is a what is that? Nose. Fourth one is a tongue. Okay, so tongue. And the fifth one is a skin. Okay, ears, eyes, nose, tongue, and skin. So these are the 5 types of sense organs are there. Okay, na? These are 5 type of sense organs are there. It should be ready to use a different type of feelings. So ears are ready to give as a sound. Yes or no? Can receive the sound. Ears will receive the sound. And eyes will look for purpose, looking purpose. Nose purpose is a smell purpose. So tongue purpose is a taste. Yes or no? And skin purpose is a feel. So what does it mean? Feeling of a cool or okay? So correct or not? So sense to touch or feel. So ears, eyes, nose, tongues and skin, is it? These are the five type of sense organs are using the different kind of the procedures. So ears by using of a sound, by using listening sound, and eyes will for looking, and nose for smell, and tongue for taste, and skin is useful for feel. So clear, children, all of you? So these are the things are right to present in your day-to-day life. Right? Now you can go for the another one. Animals reproduce by laying eggs or by giving birth to young ones. Okay, I'm going to talk about the all living things are, just wait, I'll explain. So in our day-to-day life, you can see that the all living things are right to reproduce it. So reproduction is nothing but, what does mean by reproduction, Amma? Reproduction means there is a producing of the babies, the small one. Okay, na? So for example, one character of an animal is a reproduction. So one characteristic of an animal is a reproduction. One of the characteristics is there, right? So it is defined as a process that produces a babies, young animals or new plants from their parents. For examples, okay, a cat is gives birth to young kittens. Yes or no? The cat is giving as a kittens, right? And then, so similarly, birds such as hen, pigeon, crow and other lay eggs there, that latter hatch and give birth to baby birds. See here, the human beings are there. Human beings are right to give birth to the small babies. Yes or no? Small babies are there or not? Small babies is nothing but their parents, they given birth to them. Okay, na? And same here also, for example, animals are there. Animals means which animals? If you take any kind of animal, cat if is the best example, the cat is giving as a kitten. Okay, small babies they are giving. The dogs also, there is a puppy. Puppy dogs are there, na? The puppy dogs are ready to just become as a dog. Alright, and next one, plants also, seeds are there, na? The seeds are ready to grow and make it as a big tree. So these are the birds also there, for example, hen and crow and different type of birds also there, na? Each and every bird is right to give birth to the other ones. Means there is the same kind of the generation has to, for example, I will ask that dog will birth to the dog only, yes or no? The cat will birth to the cat, give birth to the cat. So these are the different type of category of the animals, or some kind of the animals or some kind of the birds are giving eggs. So eggs is giving and later it become as a hatch and become as a small baby of a that kind of the birds only. So clear, children, all of you understood, na? Very nice. The cow is also giving as a calf, right? The cow is also giving birth to the calf. Animals and plants are dependent on each other. Okay, I'll ask one question to you, children. You think about the animals and plants are right to depend on each other or not? So definitely they both are right to depend on each other. How can we say that there is a depending on each other means? So the plants and animals depend on each other for several reasons. So in a natural environment, plants are the primary source of food for animals. Since animals cannot make their own food, so they are entirely dependent on plants and or other animals for their survival, right? The plants also provide shelter for animals and birds, okay? And plants provide oxygen. Animals, also humans, use this oxygen to breathe and stay alive, okay? Right? I will explain, wait. Okay, the plants also regulate the levels of oxygen and carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. By doing so, the plants ensure the sustainability of animals on plant earth. Okay, so listen carefully, children. Very interesting and very simple one. So here there is a human beings are there. I will write there is a plants. So the total explanation about the paragraph they given as a simple explanation, I'll explain to you. There is a human beings are there. Human beings are there. So here the plants are there and human beings also there. So these are the plants and human beings. Main simple, you can see that the plants are dependent on human beings. How the plants are right to depend on a human beings, I'll say. So some kind of the plants are right to grow and receiving manure or so dead body of the animals can grow. For example, plants need to grow means it needs nutrients. Okay, the plants need nutrition. Where the nutrition and nutrients will come from? The soil. The soil, how it will form? Any body can decompose, any body has to compose in our soil, then it will give you as a nutrients, like a urea. Yes or no? So agriculture people, they know very well about this. So how you know this? This is agriculture people can identify, yes, this kind of the situations are right to present in our day-to-day life. Yes, dead body when we buried inside of the earth, then again it became as a soil, and that soil is having some kind of a nutrients. That nutrients receiving plants and can grow. That these plants can grow by using of a human beings. Understood all of you? So here this is a, the plants will depend on a human beings, right? And here, and one more thing is there, this kind of the plants are ready to eat, like for example our human beings, our boys and girls and every, you can see that. So they are all people are ready to eat the green leaves and vegetables, fruits, okay, and directly or indirectly. For example, we are ready to eat the chicken also. The okay, the hen is depending on the plant or food grains only. Yes or no? The where it will be from? The plants. Each and everyone is right, like a chain system. Everything is right to depend on others. So clear on all of you children. So that is the reason. So the plants also depend on human beings, and human beings also right to depend on plants. So these are the cycling system. Human beings are depending on the plants, and the plants also depend on the human beings, are directly or indirectly, whatever it may be, but the chain has to make. So these are the reasons are right to present in our day-to-day life. Okay, now children, so these are the plants, there is a human beings are right to depend, both are same category. Okay, so they given as a choose the correct options also they given. We completed this lesson. Okay, interdependence between the plants and animals, they given in your textbook, they given about the interdependence. What is mean by interdependence is nothing but interdependence is a main category of a indirect process. Interdependence means internally it will appear, but it is not appear to the external, outside it is not appear. Okay, now children, so that is the reason. And choose the correct option. Humans and bears are examples of a herbivores or carnivores or omnivores. So page number 211, you can see in your book, Amma, choose the correct option is there. Humans and bears are examples of herbivores or carnivores or omnivores. Humans are there, na? Humans are which kind of the example? Herbivores means whose animals are right to eat only the leaves or plants. Yes or no? That is a herbivores. And carnivores is nothing but, so which animals are right to eat the flesh and blood of a other animals? That is a carnivores. And what about the omnivores? Omnivores are right to eat the blood and the flesh of the other animals, and as well as, so plants are green leaves. Yes or no? So these two category things will comes under the human being, correct? Under human beings can right to eat this, because human beings are right to eat the chicken and mutton. Yes or no? And it means there is a flesh of the other animals. Then as well as the human beings are right to eat the what is it? There is a green leaves or fruits and vegetables also we are eating. That's why we are omnivores. Okay, and what is the answer for this? In your page number 211, I'm already there. I'm just orally explaining. In your textbook, it will be there. Once you see that 211 page number, the first option is a omnivores. The human beings are there. Definitely, it is omnivores, right? And now comes to the second one. Skin, tongue, nose helps animals to perceive taste. So skin, tongue and nose help animals to perceive taste. So which one is right to just give a taste? I said already sense organs, I said, na, which one? That is a tongue. Middle one is there, na, the tongue will give a taste to the particular food item or anything, right? food item only, or not only food item, any for example other salt we are going to take taste everything. The cat gives birth to puppy, calf, or so kitten. So which one? The cat is giving birth to the kitten only. Cat will give a birth to the kitten. Clear now, all of you children? Understood na? So this is a very simple and very easy. So right? So that's all for today class, and next we are going to give a question and answers to you all children. Okay na? Right, that's all.